Good morning children, welcome to today's section. In our last class we were discuss about write functions and also how to use append functions. Okay, that syntax, then the strict function, that everything we were discuss in our last class. Today let us learn some sample programs using with these write functions. See the program, create a file to hold some data. Here the file object name is fileout, then fileout is equal to open student.dat w for write mode, then for I and range file print I. Okay, this should not need of this statement, so that one we can delete. It's just to check the value of I, so that one we can delete. Then here name is equal to input, enter name of a student. Okay, so when it prints on screen, then you can enter the name, then fileout.write name. So the whatever the name you entered through this keyboard, that name you can write into the file. Which file? Student.dat. Okay, fileout is the object name of, or the file handle of student.dat. So the name you can write into student.dat, then fileout.close. Okay, so let us check what will be the output. So now I am running the program. So the first statement, enter name of a student. So here I am giving 1. Then again I am giving second name 2. Sorry. Then 3. Then 4. Then 5. Okay, 5 names I given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then program is over. Now these 5 names will be return into the file student.dat. Okay, all the names should be in student.dat. Now let us check whether it is present in the student.dat. How to check? Yes, you can click on this file button, click on open option. Then here you can choose, you see here the files are Python files. From there you can choose all files. Then you can search for the student.dat. See here one student is there. So let us open this file. That file we can open with notepad. See, can you see this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 names are printed in this file. But see, all the names are printed in same line. Okay, because while using this write operation, the user didn't give any extra new line character. So if you want to write in separate character, is it's on user's responsibility to give extra new line characters in the program. Okay, so let us move with our next program. Here I am opening our next program. So click on this open option. Then for write function I open the second program. See, this is the program to create a file with some names separated by new line characters without using a write function. Okay, without using a write function. So this, by using this in this file, in this program, this one is used to write some new line characters without using write function. So first we can open student1.txt. Here I am opening a new file student1.txt. Then list. Okay, here I am using one list. Then for I in range of 5, name is equal to input, enter name of student, list 1 dot append name plus slash n. See here student 1. Okay, student 1 is a file. Then we are using append. Okay, then here we are adding one slash n character. Can you see this plus symbol? That means this name plus this slash n character will add. Then fileout.write lines list 1. So all the names will be added to this list. So let us check what will be the output. So here I am running the program. See, first enter name of student. So here I am giving again this 1. Then 2. Then 3, 4, then 5. Okay, so let us check what will be the output in the file student1.txt. To check this, you can click on this file, then click on open. Then you can here you can choose all files. Then you can look for student1.txt. See here we have student1. So that one you can open with notepad. See here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it is printed in separate lines. See here we are using append function. Okay, now let us run this program again. Then let us check what will be the output. So I am running the program again. So here we can give the data. So the first one, enter name of a student. Here I am giving 6, then 7, then 8, then 9, then 10. Okay, so 5 more data we entered here. Then again we can check what will be the output. Then you can click on this file. Click on open option. Then choose all files option. Then you can search for student1.txt. See here we have student1. That one you can open with notepad. See here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, then let us move with another program. Click on this, then open, then select another program. Here I am choosing one more program. See, this program to get roll numbers, names and marks of the students of a class, get from user and store these details in a file called marks.txt. Okay, so here count is equal to, here we have one variable, count is equal to int input, how many students are there in the class. Okay, here how many students, then file out is equal to open marks.dat wmod for in range count print, enter details for student. Here you can give your details. Here I plus 1. Then roll number, into roll number, name, input name. Then marks is read as floating point. Then REC is for record, str roll number plus. Then this slash, comma, name, comma, str of marks. See, REC is a string variable. That's why the roll number, now we read this roll number as integer. That's why here we are converting this into str. Then here also str of marks, floating point marks also convert. Then file dot write rec. Now let us run the program. See here, first it asks for how many students are there in the class. Here I'm write 2. Then enter details for student 1 below. Here the roll number 1, name I'm giving 1, marks I am giving 25. Then enter details for student 2. Here I am giving roll number 2. Then the name is 2. Then marks equal to 24. So this much details will be entered into the marks.dat. Now let us check whether it is entered into this marks.dat. So click on this file button. Then click on open option. Here you can choose this one as all files. Then you can look for mark.dat. See here we have the marks. So you can open with notepad. See here, first roll number 1, then name 1 is printed, then 25.0, then 2, then the roll number 2, then 24.0. Okay, these things are printed there. Then we can look for one more program. Then open. Here I am choosing one more program, WR4. See this program. This program to add two more students details to the file created in WR3.py. See, WR3 is a file to enter marks of students. Okay, so we can add two more students name, two more students details into this file. Now we enter two students details only, that is student 1 and student 2, and their marks and roll numbers we entered into marks.dat. So here we have the program to add two more details. That's why file out is equal to open marks.dat a for append. Then for I in range 2, print enter details for student I plus 1. So first student details we can read from here. Their roll number is equal to int, input roll number, name is equal to input of name, then marks float input marks. The record are str of roll number plus name plus str marks plus slash n. So this record will write into a file marks.dat by using fileout.writeRec. Then fileout.close. Okay, after that, after writing the record into the file, we can close the file marks.dat. Now let us check what will be the output. See, here you can add two more students details. So enter details for student 1. Here I am adding 5. Sorry, roll number. Roll number I am giving 5. Then name I am giving 5. Marks I am giving 20. Then enter details for student 2. Roll number I am giving 6. Then name I am giving 6. Then marks I am giving 23. So now we enter two more students details into the marks.dat. So let us check whether it is entered into the file. So click on this open option. Here you can choose it as all files. Then you can search for marks.dat. See here the marks. So open with notepad. See here. Now you can see two more records is added into this file. Okay, so this one is a marks file. So first we entered two records, then now we enter two more records. That records also added without overwriting. That means the given records will be added at the end of last records. So this is the use of append function. Now let us move on with one more program. To open a program, click on this file button, click on open option. Here you can search for your program. Here I am choosing WR5, our next program name is WR5. Click on this open option. So this program to display the content of file marks.dat created through program WR3 and WR4. See, WR3 is a program to enter details of students, and WR4 is a program to add two more student details, and this program is to display contents of a file marks.dat created through programs WR3 and WR4. Okay, so let us run the program. Before that, see, file inp is equal to open marks.dat r mode. So we read the file in r mode. Then while str, okay, str is equal to file inp dot read line. So we read this data in line by line, then print str. After reading all lines, you can close the file by using file inp dot close. Now let us check what will be the output. So I run the program. See here, 1, 2, 5, 6. Now you can See, two more records are added to this file marks.dat. Okay, children. So now I believe you all understood how to use this write function in your program. So try to do more programs from your home. Okay, see you again with another topic, that is the flush function. Flush function and the errors we can discuss in our next section. Okay, children, thank you.